Wolf Gebel spent most of the last 9 years of his life between 1929 and 1938 living in Cape Town at Palm Studios, a dilapidated house on Roland Street with a single forlorn date palm tree in the front yard. His studio on the upper story with sculptor Lippi Lipschitz working next door. One of his most striking paintings of this time is called View from My Studio in the Sandam Art Collection. It shows a foreshortened studio interior with two door panels opening onto the rooftops of the city, laying in the north of the house. Gebel's studio also had a good view of the rooftops of the Malay quarters to the west. The present lot depicts another rooftop scene in Cape Town. The interior-exterior duality was always present in Gebel's work, with the outdoors especially captivating for him. He was, however, not really interested in grand facades and imposing buildings, but rather in inconspicuous street scenes and unassuming backyards, courtyards, and rooftops. Why this interest of Gebel in rooftops? How did the subject settle so comfortably in his mind, becoming a source of inspiration for many of Gebel's best paintings? The answer is probably found in a closer look at his life and the manner that rooftops became part of the usual observation of his immediate physical surroundings. Born in Godzik near Warsaw in Poland in 1903, Gebel was surrounded by the cramped buildings with small village spaces stacked on top of each other in the Jewish ghetto, a similar living arrangement when he was apprenticed in a neighboring village, and even in the Jewish ghetto in Vienna, Austria, to where he fled in 1923 to escape conscription into the military. In 1925, he relocated to Israel, living in an ancient deserted monastery just outside Jerusalem. Gebel, with all the other homeless occupiers of the place, had to scale the high wall surrounding the monastery every night, a wall that gave him a fascinating view over the rooftops of nearby Jerusalem. Even when he moved to Tel Aviv in Palestine later that year, the studio he occupied in Bialik House gave him a clear view of the rooftops of the city below. The bird's eye view viewpoint that became part of Gebel's daily observation found visual expression in his work when he met various artists in Palestine who had studied in Paris and who brought back tales of fabulous artists such as Paul Cézanne, Marc Chagall, Henri Matisse and Chaim Soutine. Up until then, Gebel, who always wanted to study in Paris, had only had the privilege to have met Oskar Kokoschka in Vienna. Knowledge of Cézanne's cubist approach to form and composition certainly was a great influence on Gebel's subsequent work, as was Matisse's forced use of colour, Chagall's poeticism, and Soutine's expressive use of brushstrokes. Gebel distilled a unique style of all this visual inspiration. It was indeed Gebel's interest in the formal qualities of painting that led his wife, Frieda, to observe that his art was essentially about the absolute maximum of expressiveness extracted from the minimum of material. She also observed that Gebel's lifelong quest, personally and artistic, was, in her words, to keep a roof over our head. Such artists as Hugo Dier, Maggie Laubscher, Cecil Hicks, and Lippi Lipschitz were quick to embrace a fellow modernist in the country, but the general art community in the Cape was initially very skeptical about his work. His inclusion in the Empire Exhibition of 1936 helped to win them over, but it was really the endeavors of his wife after his death, organizing numerous memorial and retrospective exhibitions, that kept Gebel in the public imagination until the 1970s. Sadly, a whole generation of art lovers missed out on Gebel's artistic sensibilities, and the present lot is the ideal opportunity to admire and reassess his merits as one of our foremost South African modernists.